You did it!
Of course. And not to conclude our business.
I have the tritium in here.
A pleasure doing business with you one final time, Osborne. I leave you to your business and go to tend my own.
Before I kill you, I want to see who you are. Peter? How can you be Spider-Man? Spider-Man killed my dad. My dad loved you like a son. Like a son. Harry, we don't have time for this. Octavius has MJ. You have to tell me where he is. I have to save her. Mary Jane. Octavius. He has a lab that he set up on an abandoned pier. She's probably there. We'll talk later, Harry. I promise.
I hate swinging in this area. There's like a very few blocks around here. Did I say blocks? I meant buildings.
Please be okay, Mary Jane.
Webs it! Okay.
I got washed all the way over here.
None of your cheap theatrics today, Cretan. I see Osborne was too weak stomached to kill you. No matter, I'll take great pleasure in rending you limb from limb myself.
My question is, how in the world did him smacking his head against the wall take off his mask?
Peter.
Oh, well. Parker. You've been sabotaging me all along. You killed my Rosie. I'm going to kill the woman you love, and then I'm going to kill you.
No one else is going to die. This ends now.
Indeed it does.
You know, if you think about it, this actually is a little bit... Oh, crap. I forgot about this. Wait. Oh, no, wait. This is where it's stabilized. Then once you turn off the switch... Oh, wait.
That's one, but how many of these things does he have scattered around this place?
I started noticing it turning red. Ow. Ooh.
Don't lose, Peter.
Great. What would an out-of-control fusion reaction be without...
Oh, there's five. I forgot about that.
That's one.
Okay.
How many
unfair.
Of these
unfair.
Are scattered around this place?
Oh, you gotta be kidding me. My spider sense was going like crazy. Ah, I was gonna try and grab that. Okay, how's... Okay, I can make it. Nope! Oh, thank you, Lord. this button. Okay, gotta get the button.
That's one. But how many of these things does he have scattered around this?
Oh! How did I do that? Okay, that made me pee. I wonder if this becomes a little bit more stabilized when you hit all the switches. Why'd I do that? And I will say this. Since Mark Webb is actually a little bit more accurate to the comics with how characters are. I mean, Sam Raimi got Green Goblin right and all that, but you know, with Mark Webb, since he tries to get the characters more like their comic book counterpart, I can't wait to see what he does with Doc Ock. Well, that is, if he's actually connected to Doc Ock.
The city will be destroyed!
Well, only you shall be destroyed today, murderer.
Okay. Stop it. Stop throwing me like a ragdoll.
This is our Rosie.
But no, like, if Mark Webb is still signed on with the Amazing Spider-Man, you know, once, because, I mean, he's not going to stay on forever, of course. But, like, if he does, I would love to see what him and other people have to offer with Doc Ock. Because I would love to see the Master Planner. Like, the Master Planner
the
story arc.
The doesn't seem to be responding. There must be another switch somewhere. This experiment will prove my genius for all
I'm gonna
time.
I'm going to get it. Yep, I knew it. Oh, here's the last switch. Sweet.
That should do it. Wait a second. The reactor. The energy field is super concentrated. I'm in trouble. Why didn't that work? I switched everything off just like last time. It just isn't fair.
No. My shield.
No more shield, huh? That sounds like my cue.
Yep, this is where it's stabilized. Good.
I despise you.
Okay.
I will dare call it through.
Smell me.
You know, it would really help if you don't throw me like a ragdoll.
Fight me! Stand and fight me!
Why you gotta throw me in the water like that, man?
Hurt anyone.
I got this weird...
that should do it.
I got this weird saying now. It's like, nothing to my girlfriend or anything, but like, we were playing Dead Island. And I was playing as the black guy. And I don't remember what... Oh my god, he's attacking with all arms.
You'll catch you out here, your legs off.
Okay.
Away with you. What? Hit him again? What
this is probably the hardest
idea.
Fight you have with him. Seriously.
I don't want to hurt anyone.
Oh, you're quite wrong about that.
I think my buttons on the GameCube controller are freaking...
That's still coward.
Running late or something.
Fight me! You're a fool to get so close.
Those arms...
When I catch you out there, your legs off. Fight me! Stand and fight me! Ah. Stay back, insect. Ah. Stand still, you coward. When I catch you out there, your legs off. You will die. Stand still, coward.
Alright, Doc. Down for the uppercut. Where are you running off to?
This is fitting vengeance for my poor Rosie. Fight me! Stand and fight me! Stand still, you coward.
Oh, God. I threw him right in the water. Alright, I'm gonna try something. It's a little ballsy.
Take this!
Ah!
What have we done? What have I done?
Dr. Octavius, we have to stop that reactor before it's too late.
This is bad.
There's only one thing to do. Get the young lady out. I'm sorry, Peter. You weren't to blame for the accident. My hubris, my vanity cost Rosie her life. Now I must set things right.
Tried a couple of times, but
I think a part of me always knew.
Now you see why I can't be with you.
God, his eyes look so weird.
I was selfish to ask you. You should marry John.
Peter.
Come on in. It's open.
Expecting someone?
MJ, you're supposed to be getting married. You...
I made a decision. This involves both of us, Peter. And you need to trust me to make my own choice. I know who you are. I know the life I'm choosing. And I want to be with you. That's the way it is. Deal. Go get him, Tiger.
Mary Jane, the girl next door, the girl I love, and now the girl waiting for me at the end of the day. Fate handed me amazing powers, and with those powers came a burden of responsibility. Somehow, though, having her with me makes that burden lighter. Still, in the end, it's mine to bear. After all, there's still only one. Spider-Man.
This has got to be the most boring credits for a Spider-Man game ever. Alright, so here is my review for Spider-Man 2. What can I say? This is, you know, a lot of people have always said this. Though personally, I don't consider this my favorite Spider-Man game. It is one of the best Spider-Man games. You know, the web swinging is not the most realistic you can get. I think with Web of Shadows, that's the most realistic. Because, you know, he does all the comic book twirls and, you know, acrobatic moves while he's swinging. So I do think it's more realistic in that game. But, you know, I have to say, a lot of this game is actually pretty funny. You have a lot of replayability. You have a whole bunch of collectibles. Though I will say, I actually did get most of the collectibles when I was playing this, like, years ago. And it just doesn't feel as rewarding when you don't get achievements or trophies. I will say that. I guess playing like 360 and PS3, you know, that kind of spoils you when you're doing collectible stuff. Because you don't really get a reward after it. Actually, that's one thing. I will say this. When it comes to replayability, there is a lot of stuff to do. But I kind of wish you got more rewards out of it. Actually, I wish you got rewards out of it anyways, because there's really nothing to do. Like, there's really nothing you unlock once you get everything. And that makes it a little boring. Story-wise, I think it's okay. You know, when it comes to movies, like games based off of movies, sometimes because Amazing Spider-Man the game didn't take anything from the movie besides, you know, taking place afterwards. You know, they always take the movie plot but then add an even bigger plot, which, you know, it can get jumbled up, and that gets kind of I guess, you know. I mean, like, not saying the game would be bad or anything like that, it's just, it gets a little, back then, it kind of gets a little boring. Well, not boring, but it's just... How can I describe it where it makes sense? I really don't know. I really don't know how to explain it without it making sense. But, yeah. Yeah, story-wise, you know, I think the Black Cat story was good. I actually do prefer that over the story we got in Spider-Man 2, you know, vice versa. In the movie, he starts losing his powers because he's feeling distance from Mary Jane or something like that. He's not living the life he wants. He just doesn't feel like being Spider-Man anymore, blah, blah, blah. I actually do prefer I wish they actually kept Black Cat in the movie and actually used story elements from this game into that one instead of what we got. Because I think it would have made it even better, because that way we see a little bit more of Spider-Man, but we also see the Peter Parker side, where, you know, it's Peter, you know, because when he's Spider-Man, he has this entire different personality. And, you know, with Black Cat, you know, like we saw in this game, you know, he has a mixture of it. He still acts like Spider-Man most of the time, but he also has that Peter Parker side where he's questioning what he wants. And that's something that's always been about Peter, is that his life is not perfect. You know, ever since he became Spider-Man, he's just had even before he became Spider-Man, his life's been pretty much crap. So, with that being said, I do think if they added Black Cat to the main story of... Not main story, but like a side story to Spider-Man 2, I think we would have... I think personally it would have been a better movie. Though I don't really think you need to add the Russians and the mech suits. I think you could have done without it, had something different, maybe a second villain, like a small second villain, like, say, the Rhino. But yeah, I honestly just prefer that. The story involving... Actually, there's only three stories. The movie story, the Black Cat story, and the Shocker story, which is the smallest one. Villain-wise, I actually just realized there's not a lot of villains you face in this one. I mean, all you really face is Shocker, Rhino, Doc Ock, and I think that's it. Huh. And I know in the first movie game, I think you face a little bit more, maybe one or two. Let's see, Shocker, Vulture, Scorpion. I think one was a Spider Slayer. I think, I'm not sure, I think it was a Spider Slayer. Or like a version of it. But yeah, overall, I think this is a great game. It's just not one of my favorite Spider-Man games. It's definitely in my top five. But overall, good. Voice acting, a little eh. But then again, it's a movie game that was made a while ago. And usually voice acting for movie-adapted video games are okay at best. And let me just say, I am planning to do, which just should be obvious, I'm planning to do a Amazing Spider-Man 2 Let's Play, so look forward to that. I think that looks like a great game. You know, the whole concept with Kraven actually being a mentor to Spider-Man. I forgot about Mysterio. But yeah, the whole Kraven being a mentor to Spider-Man, that seems pretty cool. But yeah, that's pretty much all I can really say about this game. I'll see you guys next time, and I hope you guys enjoyed the Let's Play.